Hello, this is Siddharth Dhamber from Chicago Arthritis and Regenerative Medicine. Today I would like to talk about frozen shoulder and how orthobiologic treatments can be helpful. So frozen shoulder is a curious condition. It's one where typically after either some kind of mild trauma, mild chronic rotator cuff tendinitis, your shoulder can develop a response where it gets very tight and restriction in range of motion. The entire cause of it is not understood. We know that it can be more prone in people that have certain metabolic disorders, including diabetes, in addition, after a certain trauma. But what's remarkable is that in general, it's not dependent on the degree of a rotator cuff tear. So as an example, this may be more related to a overreaction to an inflammatory trigger where the nervous system results in a stiffer shoulder. So an example of a patient recently was where he has some mild rotator cuff tendinitis and he developed a frozen shoulder on the left side. Treatment for him, based on a thoughtful orthobiologic approach, regenerative medicine approach, was to use what's called platelet lysate, which is essentially just the growth factors from the platelets from your own blood. Use that to help stretch the shoulder joint and capsule, and then go through a physical therapy process to really maximize his range of motion. That's led to him going from really severe limitation in his range of motion to now where he can do overhead activity as well as push-ups. He's still having some pain. He's about 50% better in terms of pain. He'll come back in for another platelet-rich plasma treatment, now just focused on the rotator cuff, to sort of get him over that hump and give him more pain relief and continue to improve his function. The keys here are understanding how to use orthobiologics in the right setting, understand the condition properly, and understand that a layered approach will give him a better result longer term. Thank you for your time. Leave me your thoughts. Live well. Have a good day.